Hi guys, welcome to WebSensePro, welcome to another video, and it's a feature release video. Exciting news, Dawn 15.0.0 has been released. So all of the free theme have now 15.0.0, and we'll be going through the latest features which they have added from the release notes of Dawn for 15.0.0. So these features are released all over the free themes, but we will be checking out the Dawn version as it's the most installed and the most used theme which have been used in Shopify. And one other thing, other than having the feature release, we'll be also discussing the Shopify color swatches built-in feature. So in last winter edition update, they announced that they'll be adding feature to add color swatches without needing any app. So you'll be able to use meta objects to add color swatches on product page. They released that on the collection filters, but it wasn't yet visible on the product page because category meta field was not available. But they have added this, and I'm going to walk you through at the end of this video how you can add color swatches to your Shopify product page using native features of Shopify without any custom coding, without any app, all within the Shopify functionality. So let's go over the theme release features to go through what other features they added. So as you can see on my screen, I have release notes showing up, which is for Dawn 15.0.0. And the first point, which says that they have added support for combined listing products with over 2000 variants, including several enhancements for B2B online store and localization improvements. So Shopify is claiming that they have added the feature to add more than 2000 variants. And as you can see on this line, support for products with over 2000 variants when released. When released is a word where they have confused, because I have tested that and it's not currently accepting the variants more than hundreds. They are saying that you can add 2000 variants when released, meaning it's not released yet. So let me show you on my development store. So I have this product with color swatches, and so that's the product where I have color. Now I'm going to add more variant options and show you guys that we basically cannot have more than 2000 variants as of now. So let's try adding some more variant options. I'm going to add size. Why it's not showing size? Let's add in the custom options. Okay, now we have size showing up. Small, medium, large, extra large. Click on done, click save. Okay, our product haven't reached yet the 100 variant limit. So I'm just trying to add more variant options. So I can show you guys that we are unable to yet add 2000 variant options. Material. Let's add some material on this product. Done. Click on save. Okay, haven't yet reached the 100 variant mark. So I'm going to increase my colors. Okay, now here you can see that it's showing up the error that this product cannot have more than 100 variants. To save, remove some option values. So we still have that 100 variant limit, and they have mentioned it on their last winter edition update as well, that they'll be releasing that soon, but it hasn't released yet. So you cannot add 2000 variants as of now, but soon you will be able to have more than 2000 variants as per the claim of the Shopify. Okay. Now let's check out the next point, which is support for combined listing. Now what is that? Support for combined listing is currently just for Shopify Plus, and we can read more about combined listing here. I link this article on the video description so you can read as well. Use Shopify's existing product model to create combinations of multiple child products under a single parent product. So you can have multiple child products under one parent product. When a customer views the parent or child product in your online store, they will see a single product with all of the options available them across all of the child products. And it's not like the bundle thing. So when you buy the bundle, it manages the inventory within the bundle form, but it's currently different. So example you can see here. So if you have a shoe that comes in 3 colors in 10 sizes and you have each of the colors as a separate product, then you can create a combined listing that displays all 3 products on the same product page along the 10 sizes for each. So that's a pretty basic and good example to explain how the combined listing works. I'm also going to demo you guys if that is available in a development store, but unfortunately we cannot create Shopify Plus development store. That's why I'm unable to demo you this features yet, but hopefully if I have any customer for Shopify Plus, and if you are looking for our help with the Shopify customization, do contact us, link in the description. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. We keep creating these type of videos in order to help you guys with Shopify theme development, adding more features. We have created videos for a lot of different sections which are available for free in our YouTube channel. So don't forget to subscribe our channel. Okay, now let's discuss the third feature which they have added, which is for structured data for product and article drops generated by new structured data liquid filter. So let's first understand what's structured data. So structured data is a rich snippet which you will add for search engine optimization, and it's a really important feature of search engine optimization. So when you add any product review apps and when you have product reviews on your store, like 4 or 5 reviews, it will show that rich snippet and stars on Google search listing. And now you can add that feature within the liquid filter in product page and article page. That's what Shopify is telling. And let me give you the example of what is rich snippet. So let's search for any of the product. So as you can see, we have different products showing up. And so that's the product listing. That's the meta title, which we have men's V-necks, effortless styles and comfort. That's the meta title. That's the meta description. And that's the rich snippet where we have price showing up, where we have stars showing up. If you have product reviews on your product page, and like just like this one. So this one have like 6 to 35 votes, rating showing up and the price showing up and the variant availability, stock options, in stock, out of stock, that's also showing up. So that's the feature which they have added within the structured data liquid filter. So liquid is a programming language for coding themes, and you can add now structured data liquid filter. We can read more about structured data liquid filter in Shopify documentation. So let's Google that out so I can show you guys a documentation. So here's the documentation where you will see what is the output of that liquid filter. So that's a little technical part. If any one of you is a theme developer, that might be helpful for you guys. That's the filter which we'll be using. So product object and then structure data filter. And that's the output which we'll be having, which is in the JSON format as per the schema.org, which is responsible to display rich snippet within the search engine listing. And you can do the same thing within the blog post article. So that's it for the structured data liquid filter. Now we will discuss this point where we have a possibility to enable disable display of customer avatars in the Shopify admin without editing code. Now we can enable and disable that. So when you sign up to any Shopify store and when you go to my account, there's a small avatar showing up which is automatically connected with your email. Now you have the option to enable and disable in Dawn 15, which is not available in Dawn 14. So let's go and install the Dawn 15 because that's the only change where we will need to add the latest version of the theme. So let's go to online store and add our Dawn version 15. And let's add our Dawn version 15. Click on add. and our Dawn 15 has been installed. While it's being installed, guys, there's a promotion going on where you can sign up for your new Shopify store if you haven't yet signed up, just for $1 per month. Limited time offer, link in the description. Use the link in the description to avail that offer. Okay, our Dawn version 15.0.0 has been installed. Now we'll go to customize, where I'm going to show you guys where you can have the option to enable and disable the avatar option. So go to customize and click on header, and from here header, scroll down where you'll have the option of enabling and disabling the avatar, which shows up when you are signed in using a Shop app. So Shop is an app which is available in Android and iOS, where all of the products from all of the stores are showing up, and you can buy those products using this app called Shop. Okay, let's move on to the next one, which is new extra large font size options for header. So guys, in theme customize setting, if we go to header, we don't have any option for extra large size as showing up in our theme release notes. New extra large font size option for headers. I am not seeing anywhere the option to change the font size option for headers. And even if I go to settings and then typography, I see the font size scale, but there's no specific option for headers where we can just increase the header font size. So there's no option for that. And let me know if you guys find that, because I wasn't able to find that. Now, as I told you guys, that Shopify have added the color swatches feature, and I'm going to tell you guys at the end of this video that how you can add color swatches to your product page without any app, without any code editing, without adding any section within the Shopify built-in settings. So let's do that. So we already have Dawn 15 installed, and I'm going to publish that. Click on publish again so I can show you guys, because in the other theme I have a lot of customization already made. So let's preview that theme and see how currently it looks like. Then I'm going to show you guys how you can add color swatches. I'm going to close down the tabs which I don't need. Okay, so that's our fresh Dawn 15, and if I go to the product page with the color swatches previously I had, that's how it currently looks. But now we will create a new product, and I'm going to show you guys how you can add color swatches with the latest feature which Shopify have. Okay, now let's click on products and then click on add product here, and I'm going to name it test color swatch just to show you guys how it's going to work. And let's add in some images. So let's add in black and brown here. Okay, that's fine. Perfect. Now what we have here is category meta field where you can see colors, right? So first we'll click on it, and we will have option of these colors showing up, and we can simply select black and brown which we have, right? Let's add in and hit save. And now after adding the category meta field and saving, we will just add our color option from variants. So click on add options here, and then you can see that we have already showing up connect meta field, right? So click on that, and now you can see it automatically added our color from black and brown, which is connected with this category meta field, which is basically meta object which is pulling up here. So if I click on content here and then meta objects, you can see that we have created this category meta field within meta objects, where we have options of color black and brown, and we can also add custom colors. So if you want to add custom colors, simply click here. Okay, so now it's saying that the meta field is connected to a variant option. We can adjust the values directly there. So click here, and we have the option to add colors here directly, right? So these are the default colors where we have a lot of options to add colors, and we can add custom color by clicking on add new entry. We can label our color. We can select a color from this color picker, or we can select an image as well. So if we want to add image as a swatch, we can do that as well. Now let's try doing that. And custom swatch, let's name the custom swatch, sorry. and leave the color, select the image. Let's select this image, click on done and see how it looks. Click on save. Okay, we'll have to add the base color, which is let's select any of the color here, clear, click on save to see how it looks. Personally, I'm also playing with these color option for the first time and I thought to create a video, so pardon me if you I feel that I'm not practiced with that, because it's a new option and I haven't played with it before creating the video. I'm just including that part in a rush to make sure you guys are aware of the new features which Shopify released. Now let's preview the product. And now you can see we have these color swatches showing up, but they are grayed out because we haven't added any pricing and we haven't added any quantity. So let's add in that. I'm gonna add the dummy prices and add the dummy quantity and click save. Now let's check that out. Click refresh. And here we go. You can see that we have color swatching showing up and we have this image swatch also showing up. And I'm not sure right now how we can increase the size of these color swatches, but if you want me to create a separate video, because the video is getting long and I don't want you guys to be bored, so if you want me to create a separate video for these native color swatches feature, category meta field feature which the Shopify have added, let me know in the comments below and I'll create a separate video for you guys. And that's it for this video. Until next video, have a great day.